What happens if you have more than one spring in a system? So we're going to look at something called multiple spring systems. Now, you can connect springs with different spring constants, either in a series or parallel arrangement. Let's start off by looking at a parallel arrangement. So we have spring number one here, spring number two here, K1, K2. Okay, and I'm going to pull this thing with a certain force F. Now, remember, when you have springs in parallel, all right, what must be the same for both springs, same, is the extension of the springs, right? Because if you pull this thing, whether you like it or not, if this thing moves in one direction, the two springs have to move with the same extension, okay? And that is very crucial. And so also the other thing to understand is that this F over here, there'll be a certain force here, F1, and a certain force here, F2. Okay, F1 plus F2 must then add up to give you F. All right, so basically, I can say that K1 times X plus K2 times X must equal to F. All right, and so if I think about this now, all right, you can see that I can, of course, say K1 plus K2 X equals to F. And so I can think of now an overall spring constant for the combined spring over here. And so we can say that F equals to this new spring constant X, which we'll call K effective. And so for springs in parallel, K effective is simply the sum of the individual spring constants in the parallel system. Okay, now let us look now at series arrangements. Okay, so I could now have a spring over here and another spring over here. Let's call this K1, K2, and I pull this system with a force F. Now, in this thing over here, with the two springs, you can consider this as one string, and therefore the tension throughout the entire string must be the same. And so what is the same now for all the springs is F. Okay, and so this F must equal to the force on this spring and must equal to the force on that spring. And so K1 times X1 must equal to K2 times X2, okay, assuming that X1 is the extension of this spring and X2 is the extension of this spring, which, well, equals to F. Very interesting. And so if now I try to think of an overall spring constant, then F, okay, equals to some K effective, okay, that equals to, well, for that matter, the total extension now, of course, will be the combined extension of these two things, F equals to K effective X1 plus X2, okay? Now, we can now do a little bit of interesting math over here. Okay, so this is K effective. I'm trying to find an expression for K effective. I can express X1 as F over K1. Okay, and I can express X2 as F over K2. Okay, and if you see what happens over here, okay, the Fs will all cancel away, right? 1, 2, 3 all go away, and so we are left with 1 over K effective equals to 1 over K1 plus 1 over K2. And so you can see that for springs in series, the effective spring constant is calculated like calculating resistors in parallel. Very interesting result.